Hello, my name is Cheryl Johnson, and my research is called Analyzation of Childhood Wounding. My research question is there a prominent link between psychological temperament and predisposition to violent tendencies from ages 0 to 18? Child temperament is the child's emotion or behavioral effect to the world, which can be caused by environmental or genetic factors. By looking into child temperament, things have been repeatedly stated about the two common causes. Also, resources constantly state the violent tendencies such as outbursts, tantrums, self-harm, or even harm to others. My hypothesis is violent behaviors and tendencies can be passed down on a psychological basis. I hope to discover more on different evidence of these behaviors or the differences in the parenting. When a child is diagnosed with temperament, not every child shifts negatively. To be specific, a child can either be active, as in very fussy, which means hands-on or the emotional trait, or a child can be active, which means very negative behavior, which means outbursts or hitting or crying. Child temperament is something that should be known by parents or anyone that is dealing with a child. It may help adults understand why a child may be acting negatively. It also may be an eye-opener to allow parents to avoid by the surroundings around their child. I found this topic to be interesting because majority of my life I have dealt with children with behavior issues. My research was conducted by a case study and a content analysis. The case study was used to characterize data, identify trends, and to use as a basis for analysis to answer my research question. Content analysis was focused on the theory to find the connection between the adolescence of psychotheory of the child's temperament. My secondary goal was to assert that some theories may be out of date or require updating, but using these methods, identify the links. My three cases were analyzed with positive parenting interacts with the child temperament and negative parenting to predict children's socially appropriate behavior. Maternal ratings of temperament on early learning in 2 to 3 months old infants. And the last one was temperamental stability from birth to 9 years old. So basically, this is a chart, and moods and emotions mean basically the crying and the crying, or it was caused by just overall mental state. Physical means like physical abuse that was caused to the child to cause the temperament. And environment means the surroundings of the child that initially made them act the way they do. So I looked into cases that were published in the 1900s for the outdated thoughts of temperament, and then one of my sources were published in 2015, which provided the significant identification of the updated thoughts of the child's temperament. So case A was the case of the child from birth to 9 years old, and the emotional cause was mentioned 6 times, the physical cause was mentioned once, and the environmental cause was mentioned 15 times. When looking at case B, which was the 2 to 3 month infants being tested, emotionally was only mentioned 4 times, physical was mentioned 5, and environmental was mentioned twice. C was the three to 10 year olds being analyzed, and emotionally was mentioned 8 times. Physical was mentioned 4 times, and environmental was mentioned 9. In case A, the temperamental change was due to the child's community. Another cause of temperament is the endurance traits that through childhood, infancy, and even the affection of where the trauma is taking place at. Case B, the number of kicks was tested by each child's sex was correlated within the rate of kicking only during the stable baseline conditions. Males produce more kicks per block. A significant set of correlations between age and rate of leg kicking during the different attempts of the experiment indicated older infants produce more. KC was mainly about the effect of the household that the child's parents provided. This was the only case that gave methods like giving educational awards to keep track of the child's good behavior. The awards consisted of books, blocks, and matching games and mazes. If I could repeat this research, I would additionally interview families to make a compare or contrast from quantitative data I researched. Looking into ages over 18 would have been more efficient for a personality and mood characteristics being affected by temperament. When looking into research about minors, information can be minimized for qualitative data. Consent will also be needed by guardian, which could resort to less data being collected, because some guardians may not be willing to give consent for their children to be either interviewed or being tested on. Children are considered vulnerable research population because their emotional capacity is limited. So that means the infants don't really have reactions to certain things that adults could tell. So me studying infants was hard because infants really don't have reactions to certain things. Like they cry or they scream, which that's not really specific reasons of temperament. One major key of temperament is the more towards the helping the children get better. The initial thought that majority people think child temperament is the behavior children just show instead of thinking how the children was taught negative behavior. Me studying ages 0 through 18 became difficult when finding data within psychological effects because of the lack of mental capability, which had to do with me choosing younger children. For the next researcher, I recommend looking into adult temperament. Gathering data on adults will allow more data to be collected. If an interview is conducted on multiple families, you may need up to 3 weeks for data gathering and sorting. Because within the three weeks, you would need to gather the consent from each parent. Then you would need to interview, gather questions, identify the questions you need to answer, which may need more time. Thank you. Thank you for listening.
All right, my first question to you is, what might be the real world implications or consequences, such as influence on others' behaviors, decision-making processes, or discoveries related to your findings? Yes. What might be the real world implications or consequences that are related to your findings?
Some real world implications may be just like some children don't really have reactions to certain things. So it was harder, when I was looking into the resources, the experimenter, they really didn't have specific aspects of the children because the infants really don't have reactions. So it was harder for me to find like the actual specific outburst that they had. So I really didn't have specific data when it came to the tantrums or like outbursts.
Okay. Your second question, think about the initial curiosity that led to your inquiry. What other areas of inquiry might that same curiosity lead to? Yes. Think about the initial curiosity that led to your inquiry. What other areas of inquiry might that same curiosity lead to?
It may lead to either, when it comes to the children, it may lead to them, their temperament being worse, because it's just, can you repeat that again?
Think about the initial curiosity that led to your inquiry. What other areas of inquiry might that same curiosity lead to?
Oh, it may lead to, yeah, like it may lead to the child's temperament becoming worse because the overall thought is not really identified because of the the bettering of the child is not identified. The negative aspect of temperament is identified more than the bettering of the child.
What was one obstacle or challenge you encountered while implementing your research method, and how did you address it?
One obstacle that I hit during my research was my resources at some point got banned off like website, off the internet, because of the testing of the infants. Because two of my resources didn't really have to do with parents, but the last one did. So that one had more specific terms than the other two because parents was in addition to the experiment.
Thank you.